How's it, everyone? So today we're fishing Struisbaai plaat, and there's a little bit of a backstory why I'm fishing Struisbaai today. Didn't drive all the way through just to fish today. If you've seen last week's video, today's got a big part, or played a big part, in why I caught that cob yesterday. So give you a little bit background how it all played out. By the way, if you haven't seen that video, go and check it out. Caught an awesome cob, about a 25 kilo fish on a 2-0 circle hook, and quite a stressful fight, but very much enjoyable. So go and check it out if you haven't seen it. But anyway, so by the time that you guys are watching this, I'm sitting in Angola. I'm doing a trip with Zandre. Zandre is my son. For the guys that don't know, he's 10 years old. We are going to Angola, to the south, Flamingo Lodge. We're going to fish for some garrick and cob there on the lures, and just have a lekker father-son outing. And Pier van den Burg is joining us, and then you'll also see Diffy, de Villiers Ace from Something Fishy. He does the tours there in Angola, and he does some yellowfish trips in the orange as well. He's a master at in the orange. But anyway, so long story short, I had to pick up Zandre's passport in Bredasdorp today. And so I knew I had to come through, check the weather, sort of doesn't look too bad. Went through to Stolbaai yesterday, pumped some sand prawn, and one or two bloodworms to fish today in Struisbaai. And luckily, I took my rods with to Stolbaai. Made one or two throws there, don't want to waste my bait too much, and ended up catching that small steenie and a beautiful cob. So played out very well for me yesterday, and today I find myself in Struisbaai, going to do the same thing, going to fish for, not the same thing, what's the chances of that happening twice, but I'm going to fish for a white steenbras and some barkman. It's winter time in the Southern Cape, and Oeverberg area is white steenbras, Galjoen, Belman time. And with the sea being flat, I like to take advantage of the flatter sea and to fish for those bigger fish and not focus on the Galjoen. While the area that I'm fishing on the plot here, they do catch the odd Galjoen, quite a good size Galjoen. So hopefully we can find one of those two as well. But sea is really, really flat. We have an hour before low tide, and looking for a bank that's breaking, but it's nothing much breaking. So we're gonna fish any formation that we can find. You guys can see there behind me. That sea is flat. Okay, but I see there's a bank picking up there, and little bit of working water. Usually with a flatter sea, if you find a little piece of working water or isolated bank, that is ideal. That is what you're looking for, because the fish will be concentrated in that area, and you can catch a fish. See there, I'm approaching a nice rolling bank here. So I'm gonna park off here and hopefully catch you guys a fish and make my drive to Bredasdorp, aka Bredasdorp / Struisbaai, worth the while. Well, I don't really mind if I do catch a fish, just lucky to be out here and be able to catch fish. Could have sat in the office all day. But alright, lucky boys, let's catch some fish. So there's our cameraman again today. Okay, all still cameraman. Fishing alone, fishing solo, see the background askew. That is what's lucky about these GoPro Hero 9s, 10s and 11s. This is the 9. It's a front facing screen, so I can see myself. I know at least I'm filming myself. If the horizon askew, well, doesn't matter, it's not TV, it's YouTube. Lekker. Okay, gonna set up and have a couple of throws. Seems a little bit moist today. And that's where these wind cheaters come in very handy. Go and check them out on the online store, www.steenbras.com. newzealandfishing.com. The ideal for days when it's not too warm, not too cold, and you can protect yourself against the wind and against a little bit of moisture. I have my jacket in there as well, but for now it's not cold, luckily, but it might get a little bit wet. Okay.
Let's gooi.
Sea is really flat, guys. Really, really flat. Don't have much to work with. Hopefully there's a big steeny. They do like the flatter sea, the bigger steenbras. So hopefully I can get one of those. But yeah, there is at least a bank there at the back, but it's not breaking as often as I like to. As I'd like it to. Water is like a coolish. Probably 16 degrees, I'd estimate. And that's what the steenies like. Steenies and the boardman. So let's get that bait on the bank there. Oh yeah. Okay, eat it, steamer. Fix that other rod. I think I need to change my hook trace. Still the exact same trace that I caught that cob on yesterday. That's the one, guys. Little 2-0 adrenaline circle hook. Caught that cob yesterday. Just gonna replace my hook snoot and then use the same hook, chuck a little sand prawn just close, catch myself a boardman, maybe a skinny. Get ourselves a little prawn bait here. Hey, come on. Raindrops falling ish. But anyway, luckily the wind is absent at the moment, otherwise it can get cold. I can do with a little bit of rain, but the rain and wind isn't too much fun. Add one more small prawn. Hopefully Mr. Sand Shark stays away. Luckily during winter the sand shark's metabolism goes a little bit off and not as wild as in the summer months, but they can still be pissed. They do still bother you. Okay. This one I'm gonna throw really close. See, there's some sand puffing really close by, and just gonna lob it over that little sandy, or just over the white water, first white water, into that little sandy patch. The boardman, you don't have to worry about throwing far. These things eat really shallow, even the white steenbras. They don't mind the shallow water, that's actually where they feed. And I'm sure there's gonna be one here. I shall call you must fight. Okay, now for the weights. Guys, one thing that you should get yourself in the habit of doing is when you cast, you tighten up your drag. So immediately once your bait is hit the water, loosen your drag while you're walking back. Because a lot of the times the fish will eat you. Often the fish will eat you on the way back. And if you've got a tight drag, you're gonna pull the hook. So loosen up your drag while you're walking back. Right, both rods in. Let's chill. Good boy, kiss. Catch me a fish. Lesser nibbling on my bait there. Bait oysters. There's nothing happening, but I think the problem is that there's no formation to fish at. Nothing. There's no rolling water at the back. There's no bank. There's nothing. So I'm just gonna show you guys. Basically, all that we have is this sloping bank, and then it's open ocean. You need a bank at the back to pick up the crumble and roll in, and that's what you need to fish for steenies. And I've said it in my videos hundreds and hundreds of times. You need that working water to fish it, and that's where the fish feed. So I think I'm gonna pack up and I'm gonna head to Gansbaai, because I need to sleep over at my good old friend Peter's house tonight. So I think I'm gonna head through earlier and make a throw somewhere there and see if I can't find a spot to fish there. But we have to brave the elements because it is cold. Wind started to pick up and now it's breaking at the back. Well, what should I do? Anyway, I'm gonna leave my rods out for 5 more minutes, see what happens, because it's starting to break there at the back now with the lower tide. But I still think I need to pack up my stuff and go. So you guys will find out soon what I did. God, there's some ice polar bears around here. Ocean, well, it is, but look at this. Okay, guys, I'm gonna make a couple of throws just for the sake of it. I basically have an hour to try and catch you guys the white steenbras in the most horrible conditions ever. I went from a too flat sea to a way too strong sea. If I catch a fish in this, I don't know. Anyway, let's try.
Thank you. anchors under.
Yeah. Anyway, one or two more throws. Get this thing fish back. Yes. I think my boots is in the back of the bucket. I'm gonna put them on. Lange strop. Hang het, Piet, hang het.
So nou. En die viste in, jong.
Dis saai.
Ja, fair.
Look how white these galjoen are, guys. They're amongst the sand. I tend to go this white silver. Beautiful fish. Maar ek moet jou hond draai. Wat is dit?
You can.
And guys, fish that is willing to eat in this weather at the moment doesn't deserve to be in the gene pool. So I'm gonna remove this one from the gene pool and I'm gonna keep it and I'm gonna pry it. Lekker. Okay. And I see some blood now. I broke everything off and we're running out of sunlight, so I reckon that is me for the day. Got myself a fish for the braai and hiding behind the bucket here because the wind is howling. Sea is a washing machine, and I think I'm gonna go home, have a cold one with Peter, light the fire, tan a flacy, and that's it guys. So thanks for watching. If you want to see more of Zulu fishing, hit the subscribe button, turn on the notification bell so you're notified once I upload a new video. Cheers.